So here the next problem is, let fx equals to 6 minus 2x root over 16 plus 6x minus x square. The following diagram shows part of the graph of f, and this is the graph itself. And here just you need to understand one particular fact, that is, if this is the point that is origin, that 0, 0, and if we can determine this point, then obviously we can find out the area by integration. So how you will find out this point? Let's say this is O and this is A. So how you will find out the point A? Obviously here the value of y is equals to 0. If value of y equals to 0, it means fx is 0. So at this particular point, fx is 0. So we are doing this like fx equals to 0. So from at that particular condition, the complete function is 0. So the denominator, it will be multiplied by 0. So I am just writing the numerator. So 6 minus 2x equals to 0. So 2x equals to 6. So x equals to 3. So this is the point. So the A point, this is the coordinates are 3, 0. Now it is very easy for us to find out the area under the curve just by using the integration. So now we can integrate it from 0 to 3, and the function is 6 minus 2x divided by root over 16 plus 6x minus x square dx. So this is the part. Now we will substitute it, like 16 plus 6x minus x square, it is like equals to u. So from here you can see, if we derivate this particular part and derivate this particular part, we will get, from here this is constant term, so it is 0, plus here only x term, so it will be 6, and it is x squared, so minus 2x whole into dx is equals to du. So as you can see, 6 minus 2x dx equals to du. We have got that. So now the integration will be integration 1 by root u du. But we need to fix the limits also. We need to fix the limit also. So this is the particular equation from where we need to fix the limit. So again I am writing that 16 plus 6x minus x square equals to u. So if x equals to 0, so at x equals to 0, u equals to 16. From here you can see at x equals to 0 equals to 16, and at x equals to 3, u equals to, from here you can see 16 plus 18 minus 9 is equals to 25. So now the limits are changed, and the lower limit is 16 and the upper limit is 25. So this is now the integration that we need to solve. We will solve this equation in the next slide. I think you have understood the particular fact how we have changed the limit. And one more thing you need to remember, if you are changing the integration, and if you are taking something for a particular variable, then you need to change the limit in a very careful way, because if you do this 1 by root u on the limit 0 to 3, the complete math will be wrong. 0 to 3, this limit is only for this particular variable x on this particular graph, and we are changing the variable x with some another variable u. That's why you need to change the limit also for that particular variable. So this was the fact. Now this is our integration, and if we integrate this, we will get our result. So one more thing, just if anything is written like that, 1 by root u, so this is basically nothing but 1 by u to the power half. So it can be written as u to the power minus half. So else this is the thing that we need to integrate. Okay, so in this slide we will do that. Okay, so let us first take the integration limit with the integration. So this was the integration, the lowest limit was 16 and the upper limit was 25, and the integration was u to the power minus half du. And from the integration rule, we know that this is nothing but u to the power minus half plus 1 divided by minus half plus 1, and the complete limit is 16 and 25. So from here we are getting u to the power half divided by half and whole over 16 to 25. Then we are getting simple, from here you can get 2 u to the power half, or directly u to the power half can be written as 2 root u. So 2 root u 16 to 25. So now you can write 2 root over 25 minus 2 root over 16. So from here we can write 2 into 5 minus 2 into 4. So 10 minus 8 equals to 2. So the region R is enclosed by the graph of F. The x axis and the y axis find the area R. So the area is 2 square unit. So the unit is very important. We don't know any unit here. That's why we are writing 2 square unit. And I think the complete math is clear. I am doing one recap. We need to find out, this is the origin, so it is already predefined, and this value we need to find out, that is that we have found out to be 3,0. And one more thing, if you somehow sometimes if you want to find out the derivative with respect to the variable y, like dy, then for that particular question you need to find out the value of this particular point. So at this particular point the value of x is 0. So at x equals to 0 you need to find out this point. So fx at x equals to 0. If you find out this problem, then you will find out this point. Just I am giving you one example. This is not linked with this particular problem. This problem is solved here. So the answer is 2 square root. Okay, thank you for watching IV360. In next video we will discuss the later things. Thank you.